I did my headstand my normal way, and then I was watching a video, Leslie Kaminoff video, about this woman who came up to headstand, hips tipping back and the knees coming in and slowly uncurling. I thought I'd give it a go, and I've been enjoying playing with it a little bit more. So same thing with counterbalance, but it's much subtler and requires different muscles in the body. So I'll try and talk you through it, but it's not very likely it's going to happen because I'm kind of new to this. So same sort of position for head. Thumbs for me are a little bit up so that I can know where my head is. My elbows are narrower than natural. I walk my legs in. From here, I'm tipping my hips back, and then I'm lifting one leg and the other, and I have to draw my hips back to find that balance in my hips. So I've got a bit of a back arch at the moment. Then I can start to draw my hips back and legs up, and I can even myself out. And I have to stay really present, and it's great. And then to come back down, I'm going to come into that back arch again a little bit, draw my knees in, keep my hips back, slowly draw my knees in, and find the floor. And this bit's really, really important because you go upside down, everything's the other way up, which is of course a very good thing if it's comfortable. And then it's just so important to come back into the back muscle, spreading and widening out this way. And then from the centre of the back, I'll get my hand onto the back way, from the back of the legs down to the head and down to the sacrum. So we've got that spreading out and down sensation, and also a deep rest for the head. So that we're really allowing the head to get heavy right from the back of the neck here. Allowing the breathing to settle itself so that the body can actually enjoy what it's done rather than just moving on to something else. So I can feel that I've kind of enjoyed the pose and now start to come back into the back of me rather than that forwarding process. So then I'm going to bring myself back up again.
And I think for me, that's when I'm really enjoying my yoga, which is when I come into something, I rest from it, and then I come into this place, which is a slightly different place, which is, for me, it's a little bit like meditation, where I come back into that quiet place of settledness.
I don't know, I just don't understand.